Recognize the member for New Westminster.
It began with a conversation last year between Kay Johnson, a retired nurse and hospice director, and Brock Nicolson, a hospice volunteer coordinator. They know how incredibly important it is for people at the end of their lives to be surrounded by family, friends, and caregivers at such a difficult and emotional time. So working with retired educator Wendy Johnson and family caregiver Vivian Wong, they swung into action and created the New West Hospice Society. They've already held two powerful community conversations where people shared their own moving personal experiences and their ideas about how to make sure people are there for each other before, during, and after the loss of a loved one. We haven't had a hospice since St. Mary's Hospital was closed in 2004 and hospice beds were removed from Queen's Park Care Centre. But the focus of the Society right now is building community partnerships to support people and their loved ones at the end of their lives. A partnership with Camp Carey for grief counselling, creating good neighbour partnerships with trained volunteer facilitators to help teams that help people being cared for in their own homes. Working with educators, First Nations, and diverse communities so that we learn how to normalize dying and grief by talking to community members and children. Kay Johnson sums up their core values this way. It's about neighbors helping neighbors, especially in times of need. I remember when that happened in our smaller rural communities when something went sideways and we all pitched in. We all know about Block Watch. What about compassionate blocks, compassionate neighborhoods, a compassionate community? New Westminster was the first dementia-friendly city in BC and the first living wage city. With thanks to the Hospice Society and the support of our mayor and council, we're on our way to becoming the first compassionate city in British Columbia too.